Ayo, check 1 2 1 2, it's your boy Alert Gaming coming at y'all with another NBA 2K20 video, and today we're going to be answering the most asked question of the century. It's the hardest event, the 1v1 event. Before we even get started and answering that question, don't forget to like the video, comment, and subscribe if you're not already subscribed. Let's get to 200 subscribers and let's go ham. For game one, we noticed that we have the size advantage, so I take it to the rack and get the nice one-handed slam dunk. I've been telling you, my sharpshooter can actually finish, so I'm gonna be utilizing that to get to the inside. Look at this, that I've been telling you that I can actually do this slashing thing. You know what I'm saying? Defending, shooting don't matter. Off the bat, I noticed that he's having troubles just staying up on me, so I decided to do the nice dribble pull up. Look at that. My very early inside is actually very cheesy. So when I'm doing my very early, I noticed I'm watching my jump shot. He's deciding to play up off me, and that's green team. He cannot decide on how to guard me. He's playing up at the inside, and I'm playing against him, yo. That's the whole thing. We take it to the rack. That jab step is legit cheese. I have people actually complaining to me. They're saying, why are you doing this old school move? Legit, they think the jab step is an old school move. I'm telling you, that's just basketball. This guy was legit complaining. He's legit complaining because he could not guard the jab step because he doesn't know how to guard it. Off the bat here, I'm just noticing the height advantage is really coming into effect because he cannot get inside. We have only missed that one shot, which was because I just fumbled the ball. Look at him, he's a baby. I notice that I get off him, he's jumping, and we take it to the rack, and we take it. He doesn't know how to guard me. He cannot stand on his feet, so I am utilizing to the fact, like, now he's decided to play up on me. He wants to play up on me, but he cannot decide. So for me, I'm do the dumb dribble pull up. I do the dumb dribble pull up, and 2K does not give it to me. I was not worried though, because the single fact, I wanted to see if he could shoot. He kept doing the jab. I don't even know what that move is. It's like he kept just spinning back, just doing back. And then I pull up on him, force him to pick up that ball. Oh man, 2K really saved him. They should have let me just block. I've been getting some nasty snatch blocks, yeah. I don't know if y'all want to see that, but I've been getting some nasty snatch blocks. I got snatch block in the center. On a center as a small forward, so I'm telling you, this build is really demigod when it comes to defense, even at the shooting. I'm just saying, look at him leaving me open thinking I cannot shoot. And what color is that? That's green team. Come on now. The thing about him now, he's getting frustrated. I noticed that he's actually getting frustrated, and I want to finish this off before he quits. So off the bat, I'm trying to go to my hotspot to see if he's gonna guard me. He does not want to guard me, and I managed to get the air ball there. I get my own ball. I go to the three again. I'm like, yo, let me take that again, 2K. And that's green team. Come on. I felt disrespected by 2K, the fact they did not want to give me that shot. I decided, should I finish him by the three? And that's another green team. We only missed two shots, did we? It was either two shots or three shots. I think it was two shots, and they were stupid shots. Off the bat, yo, we finish off perfectly, 4 for 5 from the 3-point line, and we move on to game two. These games were like different times, cause 2K, me, I kept switching builds, and we get the first shot. We get that, yo. I'm been telling you, my jab step. If you are somebody who don't have that high of a 3-pointer, or dribble, use the jab step because it will get you open. Because I can do the jab step to the three or the jab step to the inside. Most of y'all don't even know what the hell the jab step is. It's like when you see my player doing that, that's a jab step. You know, he's not doing the tangle. Oh, right there, I do double clutched. I double tapped it, and my character does the double does the double clutch, which does not go in. When I was talking about snatch blocks, we really do those. We get it out of thin air like Houdini, but 2K makes me lag out. I was going crazy at this point. I was legit just going ham, because I really, when you get a snatch block, it feels so good because your character legit snatches that shit out the air like he's Houdini. Right here, he doesn't know what to do. I notice he really does not. He's panicking, but he gets the nice steal there. I'm not even gonna blame it on nothing. And then he comes in, gets the easy floater. I wouldn't say easy. I 2K should have given me the stop, but that's okay. We are not worried. He gets 2 points, but the clamps are coming through. Come on now. Right here, he's disrespecting me. Look at him, leaving me a little bit open. We get the full white here. 2K, please give me the full green. We don't shoot full whites here, but that's a full white. I decide to go to my hot zone spot. He's playing up on me. I'm like, yo, just let me get open just for a second. I'm not even doing that much because my dribble combos, I cannot do no dribble combos if I'm keeping 100. So I'm doing simple things that work for me. I'm not doing too much, if you see what I'm saying. I noticed this man, he's really, the snatch block got into his head. That's the thing about it. He wants to get me back for that snatch block. I take it to the rack. Honestly, he gets me right here. I'm stuck, but I managed to get him just because of the fact that I pushed him off a little bit. I'm not even going to lie. My player did kind of like a little dirty move. You know, he turned around, pushed him off. He's a baby at the end of the day, so I can take it to the rack. But I see him actually legit playing up defense on me. After that snatch block, it woke him up. I got 2 seconds on the clock. I take it inside somehow. I don't even manage to finish just because of the fact that I had no stamina. We get our own rebound. We are not worried. And we put it back up. That's the thing, man. My player does not. I am not maxed out. So, by the way, I am not. As you see, I decide to take it to that spot. I don't know how I missed that shot, though. I'm not going to lie. He got me. He should have had that. 2K, you should have gave that man that. That was an easy layup. I didn't even guard it. But right now, he's cold. And we're going to take full advantage of that. Because he's not playing up on me. And we get that shot over him. I notice he's cold. When he's cold, there's nothing he's going to be able to do. Right now, what, 2 for 3? And we are not worried. He's got 2 points. And he's just playing up on me, though. I get him with the jab step. And we take it to the rack. Because the jab step, I did the jab step, he got behind me, and I was gone. That's the thing about the jab step. If you ever see yourself caught up in a situation like here where the guy's playing up on you so hard, you jab step him, take it to your spot, yo. As soon as the jab step will get you open. I noticed that right here, he's playing up. I do a nice, quick move. That move was actually saucy just because of the fact I could not dribble, and we take it. We need 2 more points. We need a 1 point. We need 1 point, but I decide to be nice to him, honestly. I don't know if this is be nice, but we take it to the inside. I was going to shoot the 3, but I'm like, I'll be nice and easy on you, my friend. And we finish off the series just like that. I hope y'all enjoyed this type of gameplay. If you did and want to see more of me, make sure to click that, and I'm out.